my name is Sharisa, and I'm an engineer here at Agilent Technologies. I'm excited to introduce Agilent's new X-Series Millimeter Wave EXA Signal Analyzer. Currently, the EXA is offered in 3, 7, 13, and 26.5 GHz frequency options. And now we're extending our frequency coverage to include 32 and 44 GHz. Plus, we've added an external mixing option that enables you to measure frequencies up to 325 GHz and beyond. With increasing radio frequency demands to the millimeter wave frequencies, this is a great product for aerospace defense and wireless applications. In today's demonstration, I'll show the EXA's great sensitivity at 44 and 67 GHz, plus I'll demonstrate our phase noise application, which is one of over 20 applications available on the new millimeter wave EXA. So let's get started. For my first demonstration, I'll show you the EXA's performance at 44 GHz. For the setup, we have the PSG signal generator outputting a 44 GHz signal to our EXA signal analyzer. The EXA comes with an auto-tune function, and by pressing the auto-tune function, the signal analyzer detects the strongest signal within the span. This is a great tool for quickly identifying your signal of interest. I will now turn the RF off, and we'll take a look at the noise floor performance of the EXA at 44 GHz. I'll adjust the reference of our signal so that we can see it on the screen, and I'll place a noise marker at 44 GHz. As you can see, our noise floor performance is approximately negative 129 dBm per hertz. We can improve the sensitivity by setting our attenuation to 0 dB. And this further improves the noise floor performance of the analyzer. The new millimeter wave EXA comes with a preamplifier option, P44, that enables you to improve the sensitivity all the way up to 44 GHz. And now you can see that the noise floor performance of the new millimeter wave EXA at 44 GHz is better than negative 150 dBm per hertz. For my next demonstration, I'd like to highlight the measurements and applications available on the EXA. The EXA comes with standard built-in power suite measurements, which are located under the measure key. You can see we have measurements such as channel power, occupied bandwidth, and adjacent channel power. Agilent also offers over 20 advanced measurement applications that can be added to the EXA, and these are located under the mode key. Some of these measurements include phase noise, noise figure, analog DMOD, and Agilent's powerful VSA 89600 software. Let's take a look at our phase noise application. This is showing you the phase noise on the log plot frequency view. It's a single sideband relative to the carrier. A marker has been placed at the 10 kHz offset. Within this application, we also have a decade table. Can be turned on, and then you can view the phase noise performance relative to the carrier by decade. This is just one of over 20 measurement applications that are available on the new millimeter wave EXA. For my next demonstration, I'll show you the new millimeter wave EXA's performance at 67 GHz using our external mixing option. To the setup, we've added Agilent's M1970V waveguide harmonic mixer with frequency coverage from 50 to 75 GHz. The smart harmonic mixer is easy to set up. You simply plug the USB into the USB port of the signal analyzer, and the hardware is automatically detected. The RF signal from the PSG is now coming into the input of the mixer, and we have a single cable now for the LO and the IF. The EXA automatically sets the display to show the frequency span of the mixer, and it adjusts the power level of the local oscillator. As you can see, because this is a mixer, we have mixing products as well as images. And the EXA comes with a signal ID function, which is located underneath our input-output key, an external mixer, and when you turn signal ID on, your signal of interest is easily found and you're ready to make measurements. I've centered our signal at 67 gigahertz, and now let's take a look at the noise floor performance at this frequency. I'll turn the RF off, and then I'll place a noise marker at 67 gigahertz. And as you can see, we're showing a noise floor reading of negative 145 dBm per hertz at 67 gigahertz. I've just shown you the new EXA's excellent performance at 44 gigahertz, and also how we can extend our frequency coverage up to 325 gigahertz and beyond by using our external mixers and our external mixing option. I've also shown you our phase noise application, which is one of over 20 measurement applications available on the new EXA. For further information, please see the URL shown, and thanks for watching.